Yeah, I mean, I'd heard about Clarice Cliff. My family had a couple of her pieces, so I knew her work, but I didn't know anything about her. So getting the script and doing some more research into her life and what she was able to achieve coming from not only being a woman, but a working class woman, I was just blown away by it. And I thought it was a story that just really needed to be told.
I think it's shocking what she achieved and how difficult it must have been to break through in that time. And we take so much for granted. And it's a really important story to tell because it's the beginning of the freedom of women, you know.
So many people compare projects saying they're period dramas. But I think, you know, comparing the roles that I've done, the recent one came from a lot of privilege and a lot of, you know, it's a completely different time as well. I think it's interesting when people box period dramas into one because there was like so many years between these, you know. But yeah, totally, totally different world, different...
Ambitions and desires.
Can you talk a little bit about how important you feel it is for women to take ownership of their own storytelling and whether it is a good or bad thing that so many of the discussions like this focus on that, you know, sort of films, female storyteller label?
Yeah, I mean, I think, sadly, we're not at the stage where we can't talk about that yet. I mean, we can't oversee the fact that this is a female-led film and a film that probably wouldn't have been made 5 years ago even.
I don't know if that's true. I mean, because I compare it a lot to An Angel at My Table, and that's, you know, and I was thinking about, oh, do people want to see a film about a girl, Potter, and, you know, how are we going to sell that, like, now? But actually, I remember, you know, 30 years ago when we made An Angel at My Table, like, people are so keen to see stories about artists, about female artists, and people who strive and succeed despite their circumstances. And so there's many similarities. So I think it's a long, slow process, but we're building and we're making more and more of these stories, and people are keen to see them.
Phoebe, obviously, this is a character that means a lot to you. And of course, your character in Bridgerton has meant so much to so many people all around the world. Can you talk a little bit about how much that project, that character's meant for you and how excited you are to get to continue that journey for yourself and fans?
In particular with Bridgerton, you mean? It did huge amounts. I loved playing Daphne. I always will. And you know, we just finished the second season. And it's also just a project that's so joyful and was such a great experience. I have no idea what Kerry's doing. She's out. She's like I'm out.
She's tweeting that they've finished filming on the second season of Bridgerton. It's new.
But yeah, I'm very proud and excited to be a part of it.
Thanks so much.
For years to come.
Never end.
Never ending.
Season 20, The Cliffhanger.